According to the National Down Syndrome Society, 6,000 babies are born each year with Down syndrome. That's a lot of babies and a lot of births. But I feel so many people don't really know what Down syndrome is. So today I'm going to inform you about what Down syndrome is and the options after high school for people with Down syndrome. A normal person, like you and I, are born with 23 pairs of chromosomes. But as a child with Down syndrome, they have an extra pair of chromosomes in the 21st chromosome. Having this extra chromosome does not only affect them mentally, but also physically. Some physical features or characteristics are flattened face, small ears, upward slanted eyes, and small in stature. Each person with Down syndrome has these features in some way. Each person is different though. Maybe someone is smaller than the other. It just all depends on how that chromosome affects their body. As said by the Ascent Children's Health Service, that extra pair of chromosomes causes a developmental delay in that child. So this means that the brain and the body do not keep up with the development as a normal child would. So when a child with Down syndrome is born, they keep up with the growth rate as a normal child would through the first three weeks of their life. But as those weeks turn into months and months turn into years, they fall farther and farther behind in their growth rate. There are also health risks to that extra chromosome with people with Down syndrome. One of the major health risks are heart defects. This is in the majority of people with Down syndrome. Some other effects are insomnia and hearing loss. We have a Down syndrome child in our class too. His name is Jaden, and we've been with him since preschool. We all have a personal relationship with him, and I feel as though many people wonder what he will do after high school. And this all depends on his independence level. And this means that what he can do on his own, that will base what he will do after high school. So some options are living on your own. This is one of the major big steps that a person with Down syndrome could take. This means that they would be living completely on their own, away from their parents. This can be very hard on some because they are all alone and they're all independent. But many times, sometimes they'll have assistance, such as someone might come in every day to check on them, make sure they're eating, getting their breakfast, lunch, and supper, and also maybe like washing dishes and cleaning. And maybe some people come in once a week just to make sure they're doing their laundry and just keep on helping along with them. Another option is a job. And this job, this can be an easy first step. This means that they're doing a simple task, nothing too hard or nothing that takes a lot of multitasking. This means that this can help them expand their independence. So this can help them with their social skills because they might be working with other people. It can also help their independence, again, just because they can be with other people and help them expand also their motor skills if they're doing hands-on tasks. Another option is post-secondary education. This can be a big step because this can be the first time when they're living on their own, away from their parents in a dorm, and they're going to have to meet new people, so this can affect them socially also. This can also bring on new challenges, such as a new environment to them. So they are used to having high school, knowing where to go and everything. In college, they'll have to find their own way and adapt to a new environment. The Down Syndrome Association says it's beneficial to people with Down syndrome to get a job, so that they can help expand their independence. This means that they can help them with their social skills, motor skills, if the job is hands-on. And there's also a program on their website that helps people with Down syndrome find a job around them. People with Down syndrome are different because they have an extra chromosome, but they're also the same. They are also people with emotions. They have their good days and their bad days. Today you've been informed about what Down syndrome is and the options after high school for people with Down syndrome. I hope that when you see a person with Down syndrome, you'll know what Down syndrome is now, and you'll also know or have a little bit of insight to what their life looks like. Thank you.